Hello world and happy holidays. It's me, Jamangbai. At the end of the last episode, I revealed a stocking that I received from a certain bearded gift-giving guy, but I didn't reveal what was inside the stocking because I wanted it to be a surprise. I posted a poll in my community page to see if anyone could guess what I'd be building today, and I've gotten at least one vote, which was for the Nanoblock Arc de Triomphe. From the pictures that I've seen, it looks amazing around this time of year. Great guess, but sadly, I'll be building that another time. Instead, I'll be building this. For today's episode, I'll be building the Nanoblock Snoopy's house. Whenever I think of the holidays, I think about a Charlie Brown Christmas, which is shown every year. So I couldn't help but wrap this year up by not only building Snoopy's house, but also making his home more festive with either the Nanoblock Christmas tree or Nanoblock Snowman. Which one will I choose? Everything you see right here is what's inside the box, but we'll get to what it all looks like later on, because right now it's time for a holiday build-up.
Thank you.
Alright, let's take a look at Snoopy's house. To make a long story short, this is a wonderful display piece that doesn't heavily rely on the idea of purchasing the optional Mini Nano Peanuts characters. I will admit, however, as much as I love that Snoopy and Woodstock can do well on their own, not having Charlie Brown here with them feels wrong. But thank goodness I have him! I made a lot of provisions building this set for this episode, as I've done with other Nanoblock sets that I've built on the channel, but since this one was 350 pieces, I thought for sure that it would take a couple hours or more. It took less than an hour of my time to build this, and I'm truly amazed at how far I've come 2 years later as a Nanoblock builder. It helps to be prepared for sure, but I should definitely give myself a nice pat on the back. Pat 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 pat. Snoopy's house is in the middle with difficulty, and rightfully so, but you really don't see any of that until you start building the roof panels and the framework below it. Everything before that is a session of simple layering, and making sure that things like these little patches of grass go in the right spots. When it comes to those roof panels, you have to pay close attention to the block placement. It's very important because it determines how it connects to the engineering underneath. Not to mention, once you lay down the final portion of the roof, the very top where Snoopy and Woodstock goes, it could be a bit of a tight squeeze. Luckily, you can slide both panels down for it to fit properly. Once you reach Snoopy and Woodstock, it's a smooth path to the finish. In my opinion, this is a sweet spot for anyone coming from beginner level builds looking for more of a challenge. Snoopy's house immediately has me thinking back to Kirby's Dream Land from last season, as they are both from the Sights to See series. You have the main character, which is Snoopy and Woodstock here, and Kirby with Dream Land. The eye catch, which would be Snoopy's house here, and Wispy Woods for Dream Land. And last but not least, some kind of prop that adds to the scene itself, which would be Snoopy's mailbox, food bowl, patches of grass and bushes. Meanwhile, Dreamland only provided an extra tree. Or maybe it's a bush. It's gotta be a bush. It's a bush. That's what I'm calling it. Either way, Snoopy's set offers a bit more in presentation, which is pretty nice, as it makes it look less empty. Speaking of presentation, this set is fantastic. Fans will greatly appreciate the attention to detail when it comes to the construction of Snoopy's red house, even providing a flat surface for a lazy dog to sleep on, with his buddy and my favorite little birdie, Woodstock, hanging out on his tail. I do have a gripe, and it's not a big deal, but Snoopy's missing the black spot on his back. It seems like a design choice thanks to the block that's used here, so I gotta let it go.
I don't wanna!
I love that Woodstock is here, because he helps with the contrast of the entire set. I'd actually say that Snoopy and Woodstock provide that contrast, since the rest of the set is riddled with reds, greens, and hints of brown. But nothing screams Peanuts comic in color more than this color palette. Speaking of contrast, I'm going to add a few more Snoopy's bird friends just because. They're perfect. As I've stated earlier in this review, Snoopy and Woodstock work well on their own when it comes to this set, and even adding a couple of his bird friends made it better. But even as it is right now, I feel like something's missing. With sets like these, they leave a bit of space here for you to incorporate one or more of the mini characters in their three volumes of the Mini Nano series, which serves as an expansion pack for Snoopy's house. Furthermore, this set actually includes bonus clear blocks so that you can place those characters wherever there's free space. Because the space is utilized so well with this set, it's not really necessary, but I can't not have Charlie Brown or even Lucy hanging out with Snoopy and Woodstock. Because the Peanuts characters are synonymous with the holidays, I've decided for this episode that I would make Snoopy's house a bit more festive for the holiday season, using the Nanoblock Christmas tree or the Nanoblock Snowman, and adding a little bit of snow to put a little winter in this wonderful display piece. But I'll get to that in a bit. With Woodstock at the highest point of this set, Snoopy's house stands at 3¼ inches tall. So let's do a size comparison. Just one this time, because I'm sure you all got some holiday fun to get to. So here it is next to the Nanoblock Kirby's Dreamland. As a fan of the Peanuts series, I might be a bit biased when it comes to this set, because I love it so much, especially with my buddy Woodstock here. Thankfully, the space here is utilized very well, so buying mini nano characters isn't a must. However, if you could swing it, I'd say why not. Snoopy and Woodstock would probably appreciate hanging out with their friends and family. Now then, which Nanoblock model do you think that I've chosen? The Christmas tree or the snowman? Are you ready? The Christmas tree! Honestly, I couldn't resist the Christmas tree. It fits very well in the corner here, and it also comes with a wreath, so I immediately wanted to put that on the side of Snoopy's house. But I won't completely abandon the snowman, so let's put it all together. Perfect! And that wraps it up for today's episode of Jamangbai Builds, and the last episode of the year. Thank you all so much for watching. If you're new around here, I hope you decide to stick around because there's more on the way. I'll be taking some time off and picking things back up in February, so stay tuned until the end of the episode to see what's in store for next year. I'll see you in the next episode. Happy holidays, happy new year, and until we meet again, keep on building. Peace!